Welcome to Technical Founders. My name is Carlos Lara, AI Technical Founder, and today we will learn about reinforcement learning. Reinforcement learning is a type of artificial intelligence consisting of an agent interacting with an environment. An agent, you can think of it as the AI that is making decisions or taking actions within an environment. And the environment, it's pretty self-explanatory. So let's look at an example here with the game of Go, the very famous example of AlphaGo, an example of reinforcement learning. So imagine I'm the agent and I'm making some, and I can make some moves on the board. So the set of actions that I can take, so the moves that I can play, for example, this move or this move, just the possible actions that I can take, that's the action space for this game. And then we also have a state. So the state is the current configuration of the board that me as the agent, I receive. So for example, I receive this state, I take an action, and then I get a new state and a reward. So I'm basically rewarded by taking the actions, the correct actions, and quote unquote punished by taking the wrong actions, or rewarded less. So this could be a next move and so on. So this will be the example in the game of Go. Now, in reinforcement learning, the goal of the agent is to maximize the cumulative reward. So as you can see here, the agent takes an action, which updates the environment. The environment presents us a new state to the agent and a reward. Now, if the agent is focusing on the short term, on getting the immediate reward, it's going to behave very differently than if it's taking into account getting the maximum amount of rewards for all time steps. So you can have episodic tasks, which is they have a beginning and an end, what we call a terminal state, an end state, or continuing tasks, and that never end, that go to infinity. So that's the goal, is to maximize the reward, and then what we're looking for really is the set of actions corresponding to the states that yield the maximum reward. And that actually we call the optimal policy. So again, the policy is, so given a state, what is the optimal action to take in that state to get the maximum amount of reward? And so that's the optimal policy that we want for all states, get that action. So we've gone through what is an agent, what is the environment, what is the state, the configuration of the environment, then the action that the agent is taking, the reward, how much the agent is rewarded for taking a given action in a given state. And then we have the policy, which is at the end of the day, what we are looking for, the optimal policy, the action to take in a given state. Now, here we're going to run through several iterations, do this multiple times. So the agent sees a state, takes an action, then sees another state, gets a reward, takes an action. So it keeps going through this. So if you were to do this for infinite number of times, you're approximating the action value function. So you can think of the action value function as a dictionary of states and corresponding actions. Now, because we're not going to go to infinite number of times, go through this infinite number of times, we're going to approximate this action value function, approximate these values. So we do this with what we call a Q table. And this is just a simple, simplified example of a Q table. So you put the states, the possible states in this environment, and then you put the possible actions as well that the agent can take in this environment. And then at every spot here on the table, you put the reward. So you go through this one time, you take an action, you get the state and the reward, and then the reward, you put it here, the cumulative reward really, or the return. And as we go through this, we're updating the cube table. And the more we do this, we're getting closer and closer to finding that action value function. So that's really the goal. We're approximating with the cube table, we're approximating the action value function, which contains, again, the pairs, the state, and the action to take, the corresponding reward, and then the ultimate goal really is to, by maximizing the reward, is to get that optimal policy. So that's it. That is a very basic, simple introduction to reinforcement learning. Now, in the next following videos, we'll go into the technical details and coding implementations of reinforcement learning in multiple environments. So thank you for watching. If you have any questions, thoughts, comment below, and I will see you next time.